Hi folks, this is David Atungkwan here, and this is just kind of a channel update, just talking about me. I know this is me being self-centered and narcissistic, just talking about what my life's been like or what I've been up to this past week, and not too much, except I did start my internship this week, this Monday, so that's exciting. I was supposed to start much earlier, but it was like a paperwork processing issue, so I couldn't start until this week, and it's really exciting. This internship is unlike any internships I had before, and so technically this is my fifth internship. This is my sixth year as a social work student, you know, because I had 4 years as a BSW. Now this is my second and final year as an MSW student. So by May 2015, I will graduate with a master's in social work. That's the plan. But this is very different than the ones I've been used to. All the previous ones I've had are what you could consider like direct practice or clinical practice placement, where I'm working directly with clients one-on-one or group therapy, you know, clients being the population that I'm supposed to serve. They've mainly been homeless people. That's kind of my passion and my interest, you know, people who are homeless, people who are in poverty. That's why I entered the social work profession, to help those people. Generally, because I think social work profession is one that kind of is geared towards working for the populations that are the most vulnerable, the most voiceless. And for me, the population that interests me the most are people who are homeless and people who are in poverty. And just kind of interacting with them has always been kind of very enlightening and inspiring and just so amazing. I think I can, you know, if I was to write about just any one homeless person I've met, I can write like an amazing novel. They just have such incredible lives, such interesting lives, you know. And it's my desire to really do my best to help them. But that's my passion. Not every social worker like have their own specialties. And this is our second year, and it's finally starting to seem like, you know, all my colleagues are really starting to like develop their specialties. So my specialty is homelessness and poverty. But it's so amazing to be around the other students in my school who are now starting to really develop their specialty with all their expertise and all their experiences. It's amazing. I think my colleagues are really amazing people. But my colleagues, you know, for example, some are going into what's called palliative care. And that's tough. Palliative care is people who are pretty much at the end of their lives. They have terminal illness, they're about to die, they have a dying illness. That's palliative care, like social workers who pretty much are geared towards helping people who are about to die or who are dying. So one of my colleagues, that's her specialty. And then there's another one of my colleagues who's really into kind of mental health. But not only mental health, but mental health comorbid with substance abuse issues. So he's really into these clients who are kind of poor, who have mental health diagnoses, and also have substance abuse addiction. So that's his specialty, which I think is amazing, because mental health is not my forte. You know, if I become a social worker and I have to kind of deal with clients who are who need mental health diagnosis, I would be very uncomfortable doing that on my own, and I would probably have to refer that client to a psychologist or a social worker or a psychiatrist. That's their expertise that I know that I can really depend on their expertise for. So, but yeah, we're all starting to develop our specialties as social workers, and I think that's pretty amazing. Like, we are finally, like, we have an idea of, like, okay, this is the kind of social worker I want to be after I graduate and I get licensed and all that. So that's really exciting. What makes this particular internship that I'm in right now like really exciting, makes me nervous, I don't have any clients, because, well, it's macro work, it's policy work, it's research work. I'm meeting with really powerful and influential people in regards to making policies about homelessness and you know, things like that. So it's really policy work. I'm analyzing research, I'm analyzing policy, and so you know, it's kind of mind-boggling to me. You know, it's such a... It's weird, because I don't meet any clients, but then I can be involved in something that can really impact so many of people who I would consider as my clients. I could change a policy in a couple of nonprofits, and all of a sudden, you know, that changes how the nonprofits work towards helping the homeless. That changes so many things, you know. So I'm making a, by being here, I could make a huge impact. But at the same time, what also kind of has me cautious is if we make a mistake, there are unintended consequences, which makes life so much worse for the homeless and people in poverty. So always have to be very mindful of that, of doing policy work, you know. So I'm doing policy work. What's really cool is I have my own desk. Might not be a big deal for a lot of you guys, but to me that's a huge deal because it's never happened before in all my internships on all my experience in nonprofit. Like, I've never had my own space, my own computer, and my own filing cabinet where I have my own key to lock up. It's pretty amazing. And the atmosphere, my workplace atmosphere, is so much more relaxed and really friendly. There is a lot of pressure on kind of doing the work, but then it's a different kind of pressure than I think direct work that I've been used to for so long. So I think that's really exciting, and I feel really ambitious about this internship that I have this year and going forwards too, because homelessness is my biggest passion. And I have to be ambitious because right now homelessness and poverty hasn't been as bad as it's been now. This is the worst it's ever been. To be homeless or to be poor in New York City, there's never been a worse time. There's so many... the rate of homelessness, the rate of income inequality, the rate of poverty has been increasing since, I don't know, 2001. And the rate right as it's right now is just the worst in New York City history. So, you know, that's horrible. There's so many things that needs to be fixed and to be worked on. And so it's amazing to be part of that, especially because New York City is such a unique city in this regard. It is a right to shelter city. And I can't think of really any place in the United States where it's like that, you know, where anyone and everyone has a right to shelter. They're entitled to shelter. And the city operates on that. That's a legal right in New York City. So that's something to keep in mind. Yeah. So that's me in a nutshell. That's pretty much been my life this past week. Just internship and class, a lot of reading, a lot of writing. I think I really do, on average, read like at least 300 pages a week. I think that has to be my average, you know. But I think I've read a lot more than that this week, just because my internship just stacked me with a bunch of packets of reading material and to summarize and to analyze and all that. So it's me in a nutshell. And I'm also writing a lot. I have my side project, which is like totally unrelated to me being a social work student. But I've had this idea for a while, for a year and a half. I have this novel in my mind, and I really got to start spending time to write it out and just kind of see what happens from that. I don't really expect anything big to come out of it. I think once I finish writing it, I'll just kind of self-publish somewhere on iTunes or something. Or not iTunes, but the iBooks store. Just publish it. It might even be free when I publish it, but... that's something I kind of have ambition for, only because I think I want to also end up writing a novel that kind of popularizes the social work profession. I want to have a novel in which a social worker is a protagonist, and to kind of, you know, spread the word out there what social workers do and kind of the struggles and the challenges they have to deal with in their professional and their personal lives and things like that. I think that should be known more, you know. I think there are professions which are not known about by the general public and really underappreciated by the general public. You know, I think I made a video where I talked about the teaching profession, you know, teachers and things like that. They're definitely underappreciated. They're known, you know, because every student, every kid in America, you know, there's public education. So everyone knows what a teacher is. I don't think everyone knows what a social worker is. So I just kind of want to popularize that field. And I think one of the best ways to popularize something is to, you know, movies, novels, poems, you know, things like that, cultural product. And that's kind of something I want to make eventually, but in order to get there, I also want to just kind of put something out that is just a novel, just have it as like my first work, you know, that I've done. But anyway, that's my life in a nutshell. Hopefully this video is it's 10 minutes long again. I really talk a lot sometimes. But yeah, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you have any comments, you know, feel free to leave any kind of questions below, just about me, whatever. Yeah, cheers.